So today, first of all, I want to present a very simple and basic stuff. That is Tattva. Tattva is what? What does Tattva mean? Tattva means an element, right? Elements are very important. This world is made up of elements and everything is made up of elements. What I am giving you is a very huge technique. It may look simple, but the simplest thing are the most important words. Why it is called a fundamental? It is called fundamental because it is very necessary. That's why it is called a fundamental. You cannot make a building without walls, and you cannot make walls without bricks. Bricks are fundamental. So these are the building blocks of Jyotish. So be attentive. You cannot miss these things. As I just advised, these things you cannot miss. So there are 5 tattvas in total. Agni, Prithvi, Vayu, Jala, and Akash. Agni is fire, Vayu is air, Jala is water, Prithvi is earth, and Akash is ether. Now basically, human can listen from 20 to 20,000 decibels, right? It is the same with Tattva. In humans, there have to be from this percentage to this percentage of a particular Tattva. So it is not fixed. It is not like we have 22%. No, we can have from 20% to 40%. First thing first. You have to see the makeup of the horoscope. So first, just come with basics. Aries, Leo, Sagittarius, Agni Tattva Rashi. Capricorn, Taurus, Virgo, Prithvi Tattva Rashi. Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces, Jala Tattva Rashi. Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, Air Tattva Rashi. Akash Tattva is everywhere. Okay. Akash Tattva is mixed. Akash is, you know, the space. Akash is the space, the empty space. So that is everywhere. You don't have to fill the empty space, right? You have to fill the water. You have to light the fire. You have to have the earth. Akash is everywhere. Akash is ever present. Right. So in every person, this tattva is of varying degree. And in humans, it is from, say, 20% to 40%. In the fire, the Agni tattva is 100%. Say 90%. There is 99% Agni tattva in one type of Agni. 90% of Agni tattva in one type of Agni. All right. 99% of Agni Tattva in another type of Agni. So the Agni of the matchstick have 90% Agni Tattva. Right? It have 10% the Earth Tattva as well. Right? It builds over Earth. Right? So the Tattva of that Earth is there. And that is how that, what the Baru that's closing is made up of. So this point is pretty clear, right? Now the first thing that you need to do. So Acha, we have covered the Rashi. Now we come to the planets. Surya and Mars are Agni Tattva. Moon and Venus are the Jala Tattva. Ketu you also take as Agni Tattva. Rahu, Saturn you take as Vayu Tattva. Mercury is an Earth Tattva. And Jupiter is basically Akash Tattva. But we don't deal with Akash for that matter. So Agni, I will tell you to take as, so Jupiter, I will tell you to take as a mix of 50% Prithvi and 50% Agni. Jupiter. Okay. You have to say 3-4 things, first of all. The most prominent planet. And the tattva of the planet. And the most prominent tattva as per the Rashi. How do you find the most prominent tattva as per the Rashi? So you take a horoscope and you see how many planets are there. Example. For this person, suppose this is a child and now we see there are no planet in Agni Tattva. Agni Tattva low quantity. Okay. There are two planets in Jala Tattva. 20% Jala Tattva. Or you take it 22%, right? 11% per planet. 22% Jala Tattva. Two planets in Vayu Rashi. 22% Vayu Tattva. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 planets in Prithvi Rashi. 55% Prithvi Tattva. So it is a Prithvi Tattva composition, basically. Now there can be a case that there are 3 planets in Agni Tattva, 3 planets in Vayu Tattva. So it is a mixture of Agni Vayu, 50-50. This is clear? So this is how you identify the tattva, first of all. Now once you are done with the identification of tattva, now we go to the tattva makeup. Right? What the tattvas do for personality, then I will go to what the tattvas do with prediction. In this prediction part, I will just be giving you a technique. But first of all, you need to understand the basic framework of a planet. So Agni Tattva is energy. Basically, it is energy. And this indicates the following of Dharma. Energy, see, Agni is equal to energy. It is a simple case. Prithvi is practicality. Agni is Dharma. Prithvi is practicality. Water is emotion. And Vayu is intelligence. Desire. So what I told you just now. Mind is indicated by or emotion rather is indicated by Jala Tattva. And I told you about the composition. Now the first thing that you have to do is see the Tattva imbalance. You know the Tattva of the planet also. I will go and introduce you with something. Right? But first of all, which tattva is prominent for the person? Jala tattva. Hileshi. All planets in Scorpio.
Scorpio.
Scorpio cancer. Jala tattva is prominent. Is this Jala tattva afflicted? Now, first of all, you have to see this Rashi. There is a malefic Saturn with Gulika and Mandi. Cancer got afflicted. There is a debilitated moon in Scorpio with Sun, right? With Ketu, with a malefic Mars that is also Big Balheen and also Mercury. Mercury turns a malefic with two malefics, with three malefics, like all four of them are malefic. Moon is the only benefic, he becomes debilitated. All other of them are malefic.
Combustion
is also there, right? Mars is combust. Mercury is also combust. Moon is out of combustion. So Mercury becomes a malefic with Mars and Sun, two malefics. Moon is already debilitated. Even there, Mars and Mercury are combust. So you see the water tattva, the emotion is at a great problem. Emotion is in a huge problem. This is a horoscope of a criminal. He's Ted Bundy. Greatest criminal America I have seen ever. What is this? Emotional imbalance. right? Emotional imbalance creates criminals, right? So he's a psychopath. Thank you for the word, Pratham. It's a psychopath. So first of all, we see the composition, and this is a watery composition. It's an emotional person. And that water is completely afflicted. Now, when we have to see, as I told you in the starting, every person have all the tattvas in varying qualities. Everything is there. So when you are going to analyze jala tattva, you analyze Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces, these three Rashi, and Venus and Moon, these two planets, they tell you what is the reality. Should I tell you the importance of the technique? You go to the horoscope again. He committed many sexual crimes. This person committed many sexual crimes. But if you look at the Venus of this person, this Venus is in own Rashi with the benefic Jupiter. The Venus is not afflicted, my friend, I'm sorry. This Venus is not afflicted at all. You cannot say he's a sexual criminal, but he was. This is the importance of the quote. The fourth house did it. Fourth house is also the house of mind, if you just remember. Right. Another thing is, like, this was just so sorry. Let me not give it technique by technique. Let me give it understanding by understanding. So first of all, you decide the mental, emotional, psychological framework of a person. Like in the first horoscope, where we find the maximum planets in the earthly sign, we know that this is a practical person. If you give him a choice, you choose either this profession or that profession, he will choose the profession, he will choose the option which looks wise to him. Because this is a practical person, he will go with practicality. If you tell the person that you have to travel 200 kilometers to get this job, and this job will give you a 20% hike, he will calculate 20% hike divided by rent, and then will choose. Because it is a practical person. Whereas water makes it emotional. He will be like, no, I love that place, I will go there. The fire will go with dharma. No, my parents live here, I cannot leave them. And air goes with intelligence and karma. He's like, if the profession doesn't give me any new learning, if it doesn't teaches me a new skill, I'm not going to go there. So you know what? This is what I told to my first student. That before you look at the horoscope and predict anything for the person, go into his psyche and see what he will be thinking, what he will be choosing. You normally the house is 159 indicates dharma. This is just another technique to do it. House is 159 indicates dharma, 2610 indicates artha, 3711 indicates kama, and 4812 indicate running from things. I will not use the word moksha. You know what? Suppose someone is having the dasha of a planet in the sixth house. And you talk to him about spirituality, he will tell you that he is a useless astrologer. Because he is completely focused in artha. He is completely focused on money. His focus is not dharma at all. That is the reason for tension, the trine. 159, the dasha of the planet in 159, the dasha of the Lord who is in 159. The problem is, the person is not being able to fulfill his dharma. Dharma as a mother, dharma as a father, dharma as a child, dharma as a colleague, any dharma. He's not able to do it. Planets in 2610, their dasha running, or the Lord of the 2610, their dasha is running. Artha is a challenge. Money is a challenge. Dasha of the planet in 3711 or Dasha of the Lord of the 3711. The problem is karma, marriage, desire, companionship, etc. And the Dasha of the planet in 4812 or the Dasha of the Lord of 4812 indicate that the person is running away from something. Maybe a problem that you don't want to face, a responsibility you don't want to take. Or keep himself, he wants to keep himself aloof or anything like that. So first of all, you get into the psyche of the person. You know, I have a very small joke. And anyone comes to me for a consultation, they say, sir, which profession should I do? I tell them, open a tank factory. You cannot do it because you don't know how to make tanks, right? So you can only do that you know. If I tell Pratul that practice as a doctor from tomorrow because your son is very good, can he do? No. He doesn't know doctoring. Right? So you cannot talk Arabic to the person. You have to see where his mind is. What is the framework of the person is? Agni gives energy. If you see there are no planets in 159 or the planets in 159 are weak, in that scenario, the person is not having enough energy. You cannot tell him to work in two shifts, he will die. Some people work in two shifts and you read their biography, great people. Some people work in two shifts and in 1 month they get a stroke. Both the stories are there. It is 159, problem with 159. If you have no planets in 159, if 159 is afflicted, don't imagine you can wake up at 6 in the morning and do the thing. No. By the evening, you will start getting fever. Start feeling uneasy. Do 3 din jag jaoge to chakkar aa jayega. Nilesh ji.
So question here, since you said 159, 2610, you identify. Now, let's say in one example, one horoscope, Cancer Lagna is rising. So Cancer is originally the 4-8-12 triangle, but it is going to be in 159 triangle. So how we overlap, we should consider.
Yes, see, the person is running away. The person is having a problem in fulfilling his dharma because his emotion is not supporting the dharma. Emotion, water sign, 159 dharma. Emotion is not supporting dharma. Dharma is not supporting emotion. So I am in love with a lady. And my father tells me to do an arranged marriage. This conflict is happening.
So we're going to mix that. So originally it's 159, but on that overlapping, the Cancer sign is coming.
Yeah.
So we'll
come to it. So first of all, this thing is the makeup of the person. Mm-hmm. This is fairly understood. There's no confusion about it. I will go deeper into the elements just in a while. Just be with me. I'm going to reveal more things about the elements. I will not leave you here. Of course not. But you know what? The biggest problem in life. See, let me be very honest with you. As an astrologer, I don't want to take you to the la-la land of fantasies. You know, like in the last life you were an ox, etc., in the business of cold pressing oil, that I don't want. So no la la land, first of all. And also not talking about the things that you cannot change. If you are born in a bad family, and I look at your horoscope and tell your family life is very pathetic, your father is very pathetic, what it can do? You cannot change your father. Come on, not. The optimum use of astrology will be to keep an eye over your choices. So you make good choices and don't have a problem tomorrow. Because you know what is the biggest problem in life? Is having a wrong choice. That's the biggest problem in life. There was a point of time when you were given the choice of either pursuing your profession or being in a corporate job. You do the choice once, rest of the life you repeat. So the best thing I do with the horoscope is help people make choices or guide them. do this right now. After that, this will come, then do this. So coming to this particular aspect of it. For a powerful planet, or rather say, see, take my favorite example. This is Venus in a fiery sign. And you have to see Navamsha here also. The Venus is in a fiery sign. What does it mean? You have to follow the Ramayana marriage. Right? Just try getting love married to someone from a different caste. And I guarantee you, no matter how good the marriage combination in your horoscope, you will be crying to everyone that my marital life is pathetic. And no one will be able to save you. Then no remedy, no person, no astrologer. So you have to follow the trait of the tattva. See, Ayurveda is pretty simple. Your body have a constitution. And when you eat things that doesn't match the constitution, you get a disease. And you know, there is a problem with Ayurveda. If you get an Ayurvedic disease, you never get rid of it. It is permanent. Ayurveda, you must have heard that Ayurveda removes a disease from, removes a disease permanently, right? It gives a disease permanently also. Try having some wrong Ayurvedic medicine, you will know that. Right? Coming to the point again. So this thing is pretty clear. You have to follow the tattva of the Rashi. Now let's get deeper into this tattva. What does this tattva signify? And how it works. The first thing is Agni Tattva. And you have to note each and every signification. Because if you don't do, there will be a great loss. The Agni Tattva signifies father, fame, promotions, governmental favors, activeness, intelligence, happiness that you derive from your home and vehicle, the condition of your mother, the happiness of your sibling, the condition of a disease, anger, self-control, the path you should choose in life, and mental condition. I said the path that you should choose in life. That means you have to check the planets in Agni Rashi, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. And if you don't have a profession related to that, if your profession doesn't activate the planet in Aries, Leo, Sagittarius, you are not going to be satisfied. I have Jupiter in Sagittarius. I chose astrology. Jupiter is not my 10th lord, by the way. The path of life is dictated by the planets in Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. Don't forget to check the Navamsha. Never. It indicates the condition of disease also. As I told you, no, make a note. If you haven't made a note, then sorry. Condition of disease.
Shubhamji, you said Navamsha of the same Agni.
Navamsha of the planet.
Oh, planet. So if in natal chart one planet goes in Agni, but in Navamsha goes in water. So the final says, so final thing is you have to.
Just a second.
So the condition of disease is indicated by the fire signs, which is the Prashna. Just telling you the extensiveness of what I'm teaching.
In Agni Rashi, I find Moon, Ketu, Jupiter, Saturn. Mm-hmm. In Agni Rashi, that indicates the condition of disease. Find the most afflicted planet. Jupiter is not afflicted at all. He is in one Rashi. Ketu, as I told you, is fire tattva planet, fire tattva Rashi, no problem. Saturn and Moon can be in problem. Who is in bigger problem?
Sir, Moon.
What does Moon indicate in disease? Or body part?
Eyes.
Heart.
Chest.
Heart, yeah.
This lady has ischemic attack. That is a subtype of heart attack, a sub-stroke. Condition of disease. Saturn is not that afflicted, I'll come to. But Moon is more afflicted because that is Kuliga. Right? Out of all the three fire signs, Aries and Leo are more dangerous. Because Aries and Leo are fire signs and their Lord are also fiery. It's more dangerous. Right? Jupiter is not that fiery. Jupiter has a mixture of earth and fire. So the stability of earth is there with Jupiter. If you have an afflicted planet in fire Rashi, maybe you are struggling to get fame. You're struggling to get a promotion. That is also indicated by the fire sign. I just told if you noted it down. If there is the dasha antar dasha of a planet who is afflicted in the fire sign, promotion is the problem. If your eighth lord is transiting through Aries, Leo, or Sagittarius, I am sorry for your promotion. You apply it in transit, dasha antar dasha, wherever you want. Now coming to the Prithvi Tattva, you know what does it indicate? Freedom from disease. First thing. You know, I will go to the chart and I mean it. The problem is caused by Moon and Saturn, two planets, right? I will see the time when Saturn leaves the Rashi. And at that time, the person will be completely free from the disease. And if you use Chandrahari Ayanamsha, it is exact. When I taught in the class, I'll just tell you this thing. This is important. When I taught this technique in the class, I took a chart where Jupiter was creating the problem. Sorry. Mistake is mine. The freedom from disease is to be seen from the Artha Rashis, right? What I just forgot. Disease is seen from Airy sign. The freedom from disease is seen from the earthly signs. There is no planet in the Artha Rashi. It's no freedom. You live it. In the class. Just a second. So this is a prashna, okay? Freedom from disease is indicated by the Prithvi Tattva. In Prithvi Tattva, there is Rahu, Saturn, and Jupiter. All three of them are quite afflicted. Jupiter is debilitated. Saturn is okay. Rahu is not okay. Right. So complete freedom from disease will happen when Rahu goes out of Taurus. That will take time. But when Jupiter goes out of Capricorn, at least 50% of the problem or the symptoms are gone. And here you have to use Chandrahari, my friend. With Chandrahari and Amsha, the day Jupiter moved to Aquarius, just after 2 hours, it disappeared. Disease. So Prithvi Tattva indicates freedom from disease, material prosperity. The condition of mother is seen through fire tattva, whereas mother is indicated by Prithvi Tattva. Financial condition of home, not of the person, of the home. Prosperity, bodily composition, luck, change of place, business, agriculture, wife, and progeny. So if the Prithvi Tattva signs are afflicted, Taurus, Virgo, and Capricorn, there is a problem in marriage, there is a problem in getting a child. If the Prithvi Tattva is prominent, the person does business. He will be in business. Only business will give him satisfaction because that's prominent. Prominent Tattva. You remember, right? Don't forget it. I'm trying to give you understanding. Coming to the Vayu Tattva indicates fickleness, unstability. It signifies siblings. It shows the status and condition in society. It indicates your maternal uncles, enemies, secret pain, income, foreign travel, obstructions, patience, surprise troubles, and death. To the students, I will drop you this thing in the group who are in the class. Right? The Vayu Tattva indicates fickleness and stability, signifies siblings, status and condition in society, enemies, maternal uncles, secret pain, income, foreign travel, obstruction, patience, surprise troubles, and even death. So there's a very simple technique to time the longevity. 35 years each sign of Gemini, 35 years. Libra 35 year, Aquarius 35. And you see the strength of these signs. One afflicted, minus 35. Two afflicted, minus 35 plus 35. All of them afflicted are you. The water signs indicate opulence, happiness, prosperity, efficiency, philanthropy, greatness, progress, changes in life, tension, family, hope, all the grandparents, service or job, jail, misery, fear, pain, and the good things of life. You can use it anywhere. All right? Prashna, natal chart, dasha analysis. Gochar is transit. Anything that you want. It's no problem with that. But there is one special trait with the prominence of Prithvi Tattva. The person always suffers from one disease or other. Sardi mein thanda lagti hai, garmi mein garmi lagti hai, barsaat lagti hai, har mausam mein kuch na kuch lagta hai. Prithvi Tattva ka trait hai. कि गर्मी में पृथ्वी गर्म हो जाती है, सर्दी में ठंडी हो जाती है, उसको चैन नहीं होता ना उसको. यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड इट ऑल्सो, यू कैन ऑल्सो यूज योर माइंड. लाइक द पृथ्वी टेक्स आवर वे, राइट? सो द पृथ्वी तत्व प्रोमिनेंट पर्सन, एंड आई एम नॉट टॉकिंग अबाउट लग तत्व इन द लग्न, नो, तत्व इन द लग्न इज योर ट्रेड, योर ट्रेड. Your life goes according to the tattva having the more number of planets. More number of planet means what? in the maximum dasha, antar dasha, that tattva is getting activated, right? So if the prithvi tattva is there, you have to take the responsibility of the whole family. Because as prithvi, have to take the responsibility of all of us. Right, so that is prithvi taking a lot of responsibility. If the seventh lord is in a prithvi tattva rashi, your wife and the family of wife, welcome to the hood. You have to understand it this particular way.
सबसे ज्यादा क्वेश्चन आता है सर, मेरा पति कितना पैसा कमाएगा, घर वाले कितने पैसे कमा के लाते हैं?
तो देखो दिस राइट, सो दिस इज द सेवंथ लॉर्ड इन द पृथ्वी तत्व राशि विद अग्नि तत्व. लाइक अ फ्यू मोर थिंग्स अबाउट दिस तत्व राइट बिफोर आई जंप टू द नेक्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ इट. दिस पृथ्वी तत्व इज द रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज, प्रैक्टिकलिटी, स्टेबिलिटी. पृथ्वी तत्व इज प्रैक्टिकल, हैव टू टेक अवर, हैव टू टेक a lot of responsibility and is practical. Agni tattva is energetic. He is always running for dharma. This is not my duty, this is your duty. You do your duty, I will do my duty. And the problem with Agni tattva is digestion. So when he gets a high paying salary, he starts spending a lot of money. He cannot digest that I got it. So he will make sure that I spend all of it and remain in the previous condition. This adjusting takes time. So if you are getting married to a lady or a man having 4 or 5 planets in the fiery signs, or maximum number of planets in the fiery signs, you know what is going to be a problem. Saas bhoobhi jagade. Adjustment, digestion is the issue. Meri mummy to aisa nahi kehti, tumhari mummy aisa kehti hai. Hamare tumhari mummy same hoti, tum bhai behan na hoti. Behrhal. Coming to the fire tattva. See, there is one problem. A fire is very powerful. The problem is when fire tattva is activated, it is destructive. And when it is not destructive, it is not activated. That is the problem with Vayu activates with eradication of something. So if the seventh lord is in the Vayu tattva rashi, your mortal life will be happy after the death of some. Ki wo jo mar gaya bas maza. So why you have this particular thing? When it is activated, it destroys almost everything. That's why you will see successful Vayu people living alone, bachelor, not with anyone. Why prominent Vayu people having maximum planets in Vayu Rashi? This thing I have made clear, right? So don't confuse me. Successful Vayu people even say aloof. Everyone died in the family. Don't want to talk. Like Ramakrishna Paramahans, 3 planets in the Vayu Lagna, 1 Mars in the 5th, 1 Jupiter in the 5th, and 1 Saturn in the 9th. He had 5 planets in Vayu Rashi. What he used to do, no one knows. He spent his maximum time alone only. His wife came to him in Dakshineshwar. He was like, you live in that room. Don't come here. Akelapan mat bhanga karo here. And he started with the death of Rani Rasamani. Paramahansa started with the death of Rani Rasamani, right? The thing itself was Rani Rasamani wanted to create a temple because she was like, before I die, I should make something. At least a temple. This was the thing of Rani Rasamani. That's why she created the Dakshineshwar temple, right? So it's activated with deaths. There is aloofness, aloneness, right? This is, understand it like a tornado. The air is flowing every day. You don't feel its might. One day storm will come. You will know the might, but then nothing will be left. Then you will be standing on a ground. So this is what Vayu does. Either it is not activated, you are always like, why this is not happening, why I'm not getting a promotion or this or that. But he will give you a promotion. Vayu will give you a promotion when you are on the top and everyone is an enemy, including your wife. Because now they are jealous of what you have achieved. This is how Vayu works. Either it gives you a miserable life where you keep on crying every day that this is not happening, that is not happening. And when it gives you the highest position that even the closest people will become your enemies. Jealousy is a common trait of humans. Because Agni Tattva is there in everyone. So fire jealous. Whatever. Vayu Tattva. Afflicted Vayu Tattva is a sure shot criminal. Sorry, Jala Tattva. Afflicted Jala Tattva is a sure shot criminal. Jala Tattva person can be anything, but crime is behind. Jala Tattva person can be a saint, but crime will be there. For Jala Tattva, everything comes with a crime. There's nothing without a crime. There's nothing without a conspiracy. Everything is there with a crime and conspiracy. Seventh Lord, Jal Rashi mein hoga. If your wife was in affair with someone else, you first broke the affair, crime, then got into it. So this crime stuff will be there. This crime is there with Jal. The more afflicted it is, bigger the crime. Though bitching about two people and making their friendship break is not a big crime. A small crime. Big crime. But water is a crime. Prominent water lagna people backstab their own guru. Water is a crime. That is pretty simple. Jahan jal tattva balshali ho satrak ho jaye. You see Ted Bundy. Crying. You see one more chart. Moon and Mars in Pisces. This is the water sign that gets afflicted by the Moon-Mars combination, basically. Right? And what are the two Navamshas that I say are always very problematic?
Scorpio or Aquarius?
Like Scorpio. Let's take Scorpio or Aquarius. So there is a Moon-Mars combination in Pisces. Once again, a great criminal, Jeffrey G. And the watery Venus influences the Lagna and no other planet. You will start this Mars is the culprit. I'll come to it. So this is there with Jala. There's a crime. So Jala better not be prominent. If it is prominent, it have to be very well proportioned prominent. Lack of promotion, prominent, no. That creates a problem with you. So, good prominent Jal is one exalted planet, one debilitated planet. The person can do anything but will not do crime. He will not even hurt the insect. It gives a loss of compassion. Lots of compassion or loss of compassion. Either ways, this is how Jala works. I will come to the questions in the end. I just have to just introduce one more technique. Right? So this is what happens with water. See, every criminal is very emotionally motivated. It is a very emotional person. Emotion makes crime happen. You know the example Pratul was giving, you know that beating example. You talk to the person who is beating. they love so much. That's why they're waiting. Because see, earth is practical. You are not happy, you can choose your way. That is what earth is. Water is emotional. Emotion have this thing. Agar tum meri na ho saki, kisi ki nahi hone dunga. Ye kya chal raha hai? Tumhari nahi ho saki nahi, whatever. That's the problem with water. Water is locked into emotions. And that emotion can be problematic. Ant mein kare sawal ko. Just one more stuff I have to do. Now you know the tattva of the planet. You know the tattva of the Rashi. Now you should know how the tattva works. Right? Earth is friendly to fire, neutral to water, inimical to air. Fire, you can write it down. Right? I remember it. You can write it down. Earth is friendly to fire. Main likh deta hu. The fire. Sorry. Earth. Friendly, neutral enemy. Earth is friendly to fire, neutral to water, inimical to air. Fire is friendly to air, neutral to earth, and inimical to water. The air is friendly with water, neutral to fire, and inimical to earth. And the water is friendly to earth, neutral to air, and inimical to fire. Okay. Now, there are two things. One is the natural signification of the planet, and one is the planet being a house lord and signifying different houses. This is what I refer as acquired significations. Prapt kya hua signification. Son is the karaka for father. But if son becomes the fifth lord, he have acquired the signification of dealing with children also. It has acquired the signification for a particular lagna. That's all, not for everyone. So there is a tattva of the Rashi. There is a tattva of the Lord. And this is a huge technique. My friend, this is a very huge technique. And you'll just realize the importance. Planet as a house lord. Planet as a house lord interacts with the tattva of the Rashi lord. Planet as a karaka interacts with the tattva of the Rashi. Example, Venus in Capricorn. Venus is a jala tattva Rashi planet. In Artha Tattva Rashi, see, friendly is 75% good. Neutral is 50% good. Inimical is only 25% good. Same Tattva is 100% good. Okay? same tattva is 100% good. Fiery planet in fiery tattva, very good. But it explodes the fire. You remember this. It can create a tattva imbalance also. Fire planet in fire rashi gives a lot of fire. Gives a lot of passion, gives a lot of energy. Gives a lot of dharma. So that can also be a problem, by the way. Best position is friendly. Okay. Best position is friendly. Same tattva makes the planet ultra power. That we don't want it to happen. Ultra pro. All right. So Venus is the, suppose Venus is the seventh lord and the karaka for marriage. Venus is karaka for relationship. Seventh house indicates marriage. Okay. Relationship versus marriage are two things. Seventh lord, as a seventh lord, Venus indicates marriage. As a karaka, he indicates relation. By being in Capricorn, okay, karaka, if I have to see Venus as the karaka for relationship, we should see the element of Capricorn. That is earthly. That is good. For relationship, it is good. For marriage? For marriage, we have to see the lord of Capricorn, that is Saturn, that is of Aries tattva. For marriage, it is neutral. Katte mite anubhav. 50% good, 50% bad. Same planet, same Rashi, different result for house lordship and different result for signification. This is the power of this technique. As I told you earlier, this is a very huge technique. This is very huge. All the techniques that I teach in mastering the Rashi is very huge. See, I do a course by the name of mastering. After every course, I will tell you there are many things left. So we as astrology students making a course by the name master, they're getting my point. So they write these huge techniques only. Pratul have been in mastering the Rashi part one, he knows it. Right. I teach concepts. I don't teach you a technique. Fourth lord and fifth house gives you marriage after the death of your mother. Wow. No. Concept. Learn the concept, not the technique. Same planet. Same planet. Same Rashi. Two results. Are you clear about it? Let me like talk about one more stuff. Example, Mercury in Capricorn. Okay. In my horoscope, it is the lord of the 5th house and 8th house. It goes to the 12th house. 12th house indicates loss. So there will be a loss. There will be a loss of the 5th house and 8th house. But which house will get affected more? Gemini is in the 5th house, Virgo is in the 8th house. As the lord of the Earth Tattva, in the Earth Tattva Rashi, it is 100% loss of 8th house. Gemini is Air Tattva. As the lord of the Air Tattva Rashi, being in Earth Tattva, the signification of 5th house is only lost 25%. So even with the 5th lord in the 12th house, I am intelligent. Why? Because of this. Ho sakta hai main aapko gadha lagta hu, wo alag baat hai. Wo sachai se pare. Are you getting my point? So a planet, like you always have a thing, no, sir, Saturn is the lord of Capricorn also, Aquarius also, he is the lord of the Lagna and the 12th house. Or say it is the lord of the 5th house and 6th house and it is situated in 10th house. So will it give the result of the 5th house or 6th house? It will give the result of both. But to which extent you use this? But you mind it, I took the tattva of Gemini being Earth, Gemini being Air Tattva and Virgo being Earth. I have completely ignored the tattva of Mercury. I will take the tattva of mercury with, for this technique. For this technique, I have taken the tattva of Rashi that he owns, right? Are we being extremely clear about it?
One more example, please.
Real life with Chat Lelo.
After that, I have a couple of questions, couple of discrepancy I have.
In the horoscope of Marilyn Monroe, Saturn is in the fourth house. So there have to be misery, Saturn, in happiness, fourth house. Misery in happiness. But misery in happiness of life or only marriage? Let's see, Saturn is in an Aries sign. And his Aries sign is Aquarius. And his earthly sign is Capricorn. So planet as the lord of Artha Rashi in Aries sign is inimical. And as the lord of the Aries sign in Aries sign itself is also pathetic. So 100% loss. See, I have written benefit. Inimical sign, 25% benefit, that means 75% loss. I have written 25% good result. What does this mean? 75% bad result. So Saturn being in the fourth house destroyed seventh house 75% and eighth house 100%. So she had a short life. Regarding seventh house, she at least had relationships. Many. It was not like that one marriage becomes bad and the husband kills her. Chalo hariyo. Nahin. She got married multiple times. It was love marriages also. She also enjoyed for some time, though the influence of, see, Saturn is influencing both of them more than 50% negatively, by the way. Right? Now let's see the planet as a Karaka and as a house lord. Saturn as the Karaka of misery in the sign of Venus. Sorry, Saturn as the Karaka of misery is in an air sign. Airy planet, airy sign, 100% misery. Okay. Saturn as the seventh lord of marriage. When I see lordship, I see the house lord. Sorry, Rashi lord. So Saturn as the Karaka of the seventh house of marriage goes to the Rashi of Venus, which is Jalatattva. So airy planet in Jalatattva Rashi should be 75% good. So fifth lord, sorry, seventh lord in fourth house, what I teach you, love marriage combination. Out of three of our marriages, two were love marriage. But the result of misery is 100% powerful, marriage is 75%. You know the result. This is a tattva imbalance. The Saturn in Libra in fourth house is a pure tattva imbalance for Mundru. Getting my point? One more example, maja aa gaya. Indira Gandhi marriage.
Okay.
Let's see. Moon is of Jalatattva. Jalatattva planet in Prithvi Tattva Rashi. Jalatattva planet in Prithvi Tattva Rashi. 75% good. That is for the natural signification of moon. Right? For the case of Indira Gandhi, seventh house doesn't deal much with marriage. It deals much with other influences. It does deal more with fame and status. That is another signification of seventh house. Ask me why. Because there is an Artha Rashi in the seventh house, practicality. This is what I told you. Which signification pick from which house? This tattva helps you there. If you don't have a Vata Rashi in the seventh house, you are just by default, you are not much emotional in marriage or for relationships, basically. Right? So that is Lagna, Lagna versus Lagna. Okay. Right. this technique is very huge. I just don't want to reveal it yet. Right, and the 10th lord Saturn goes to Lagna, airy planet in watery Rashi. Airy planet in watery Rashi is also 75% good. But as the lord of the 7th house, he is supposed to indicate Earth Tattva because it is Capricorn. And planet of Earth Tattva in the watery Rashi is neutral only. So you have to read the marriage of Indira Gandhi deeply to understand why it is not being completely inimical. This reveals many techniques to you. This will reveal many techniques to you.
So matchmaking may be used kar sakte hain isko.
Yes. You don't want to get married to an Aries Lagna person, to a Air Lagna, Aries Lagna person, to an Aquarius Lagna person. Because you cannot get a Virgo Lagna person, Earth element, get married to Libra Lagna or Gemini Lagna or Islam. Though Gemini is a 4-10 connection, it will be good only, but still it is inimical. So marital life will sustain, though there will be fights everywhere. And how it is sustained? As I told you, we want good sustenance. We don't want bad sustenance. Right? This is a very huge technique. I'm just not telling you how huge it is. But it is a very huge technique. And let me tell you one thing. I have taught this for 4 hours in Mastering the Rashi 2.1. Still, what I have taught you here is I haven't covered in the course. So 1 hour I have taught now, and 2 hours I have taught in the Mastering the Rashi. And still I told in the Mastering the Rashi that I will teach it again. I can teach this technique for 10-12 hours in a row. With every 15 minutes a new technique, that is my style. This is such a huge concept. This is very, very huge. And this is just one aspect of Rashi, just the Tattva. There are many more things in the Rashi, movability, etc. Multiple things are there. How does the male Rashi and female Rashi work? How does the movable, fixed and dual signs work? You know what? I have a particular statement. We fantasize how Parashar used to predict. We want to be like Parashar. We can never become like Parashar. You know why? Because in the last 500 years, astrology have been based on bhavas, whereas originally it was based on rashis. So until and unless we make a switch from bhava to rashi, we can just imagine of that greatness and cannot achieve. Your astrology have to be rashi centric rather than being bhava centric. Then it will be real fun. Thank you. Nilesh.
Okay, in previous classes you have given this element table. In that you have mentioned that Earth is friend with water, and Earth is enemy with fire.
Nilesh ji, Tajik list is a separate list. This is a Vedic list.
No. ये मैं उसी की बात कर रहा हूँ. Vedic list की बात कर रहा हूँ.
Fire or water or earth friend hai. Water and earth are friendly.
Yeah.
But earth is not friendly to water. No. Earth is neutral to water. Water is friendly to earth.
If you allow me, I can share my screen.
Just a second.